Here I thought coming on a Thursday early in the day that this place wasn't going to be chaotic, but Goodwill is popping today. I think everybody has been feeling it as far as being stuck in the houses with all the snow we've had for this last week and ice, but we are finally defrosting and able to go places, and it looks like it's not just me. The rest of my little city here is like, yes, we're going to Goodwill. With that being said, I'm bringing you guys along with me. I've been dying to get out of my house, and there are a few items I'm looking for. I'm looking for clothing that is in my color palette. I just did a Colorize Me survey, and apparently I think I'm cool winter. I might be warm winter. I'll put the palette here though. I'm looking for clothes in this color. Also looking for a new book to read after being stuck in the house. I realize I need some more reading material. I'm very into cookbooks as well, so I'll keep an eye out for that. And lastly, I love home decor. I love to see thrifted finds. I'm somebody that likes to find things that make my house feel homey, but I also love to share things that I think are unique, quirky, and fun. So, all that being said, I hope you guys enjoy this video. Give me a thumbs up if you do, and make sure to subscribe at the end if you want to see more. See you soon. I told you guys, this place is packed. Okay, the color I'll be looking for today is green. One of my friends at work was kind of getting on me about only reading self-help books, but for me, it's like two birds, one stone. I get to relax, reflect, and learn some new things to try. I think we all have room in our life for growth. And these are the books I prefer. I considered this Unstoppable Influence book because I am a supervisor at my job, as well as somebody that likes to be in social media. But as you can see, it wasn't a green tag. So I did put this book back, but maybe I'll look for it next time they have purple tag day. The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People was something that caught my eye because I am currently reading Atomic Habits, and this one was a green tag. So for $2.50, I went ahead and threw it in my bin to read later. Little Victories, Perfect Rules for Imperfect Living. The book cover itself caught my attention. I thought it was really cute with the colors. Again, a green tag, so it's only $2. And I am currently trying to read this one now. The Middle Matters was a book that kind of grabbed my eye because I am in my late 30s now, and this really is a book about where I'm at in my life and kind of the adult things I'm going through. And again, it's a green sticker, so I'm getting it. I love Taste of Home Recipes, and I found this book for $2.50. I liked it because of the binding in it. I do have a book holder that I use for recipes when I'm reading recipes. And Taste of Home is just nostalgic for me. When I first moved out on my own, my mom got me a subscription to Taste of Home magazines. And I did a lot of learning in the kitchen back in those days. And I don't know, it's just, I prefer recipes that are shared from families from all over the place. And you know, these recipes are the ones that they loved the most. I remember making amazing cupcakes out of those magazines. This one was really cool too because it has the little recipe holder. So I went ahead and I decided to grab this one. They had a lot of choices for books, and one thing that I keep in mind with not only the sticker, but just how the book looks, because I do like to style my shelves in my kitchen with cookbooks for different seasons, and it's nice having a nice cookbook sitting up on the shelves. So I keep that in mind too. Naomi's Home Companion really grabbed my eye. Growing up, the Judd sisters honestly reminded me of my mom. It's really sad how her life ended a couple years ago, but this book was fun. It's full of mullets, it's full of stories and recipes to boot. So I went ahead and grabbed it. I think it will be fun to cook out of it for a few recipes. And again, it's got a green sticker, so it's only a couple bucks.
I also like to look through t-shirts when I go to Goodwill, just because I am somebody that goes to the gym and I live in a house full of guys. If this shirt was bigger, I honestly would have considered it for a gym shirt for me, because I'm just a goober like that. I like a fun shirt to wear to the gym. I'm very not serious. I'm not the girl going there to be styling, for sure. I've never seen that cartoon, that Rick and Morty show. I'm curious about it though, because I do like a good adult comedy cartoon. I wasn't really seeing anything that was the style of my husband or my oldest. Not a lot going on at the moment. I wish. I feel like I always have a lot of stuff going on. Maybe that's in my head though. I thought that Van shirt was kind of cool, but I don't think anybody would wear it. Bad boy mowers. That shirt's terrible.
I wasn't prepared to try on things because I don't have a very good tank top underneath this, so I'm trying to try on things overneath this big shirt.
This blue end cap really caught my eye, and you're gonna see that blue catches my eye a lot on this trip. I don't have anything blue in my home, but I've been seeing a lot of it secondhand at stores like this, so I just wanted to share with you guys in case you guys are blue people as well. There's actually a really cool collection here of vintage Chinese teapots. This one was awesome. It doesn't have a lid, but I love the shape of it. So unique and cool. They also had this one, which was a unique and fun shape as well. I like the tall piece of it. I'm wondering actually, was that a cup? This wasn't vintage, it was just cool. I liked it, how it had the cup attached to it. And this little vintage one looked like it was a purse. I just think it was so cute. I wish I collected them, but I do not. This teapot is my personal style. I love the 70s type of decor with the yellows, the browns. I was really tempted to get this because this is my style, but I really can't imagine where I would put it. One day I'll have a room with a big old bookshelf that'll have room to expand and put cool stuff like this in it, but I just don't have that right now, so I'm not gonna clutter my home and I'm gonna leave it for somebody else. But I really do love it a lot. Just kind of perusing through the shelves here, see if I can find anything cool. I honestly think these are cool, the cutting boards that are shaped of different states. I don't know anybody from Texas, but if I did, I would get it for them. I've actually got one for Oregon at home now that I absolutely love. Just had to adjust here so we can see a little bit more on these shelves. I really liked this salt and pepper shaker that were in the shape of apples. I just thought they were charming and I could see them easily being placed in kitchen decor. Just didn't quite fit in with my kitchen currently. They had a little trivet dish down here too with orchids on it. Wasn't quite my style, but it definitely was my mom's style. I could see her using this for sure. Those were little carnival plates, very colorful, very fun. We had a little teapot here. I guess it's not a teapot, it's a pitcher, isn't it? Come on, Raina. Know your stuff. This is a little party set for a princess. I don't know any princesses. Are word signs still in? I feel like they've phased out. I have a few of them around my house, but I'm just not really drawn to them anymore. It's probably why they're here at Goodwill, actually. I was in the market for a growler. I know where to come. I know breweries around here will refill them for ya. I was a little bit excited about this, but then I realized how cheap it was, so I put it back. We don't need that. I thought that glass was really pretty. It's too bad there was only one of them. It's hard to tell in this video, but these actually had little hearts etched around them, and I thought it would be a really cute Valentine piece to put a dessert in there for your loved ones. They had these little chalkboard canisters, which were kind of cute. Does anybody know what this is for, by the way? My guess is that it's for chopsticks, maybe? I wasn't quite sure. I am on the market for some bowls, but these ones were not my style at all. I love coffee cups. I will always stop to look at coffee cups, no matter what. Just kind of perusing them to see if any of them fit our style. And I'm not seeing much yet. I thought the idea of this cup was cool because it looked a little imperfect, but I didn't really like the color of it. I liked the shape of this cup, but I didn't really like the design of it. I thought this could be a really nice gifted cup. I don't know what you could put in it. Maybe some seeds to some plants or something, and maybe a little treat. I have a few crazy plant lady friends in my life. Put, chip, and sip. Does anybody know what the bottom of that's for? I feel like it's missing a piece. This cup was actually very pretty, and I considered getting it because it was so nice. And it was only $2, but I left it for somebody else. They had a cute little cat cup here. Good time to be having a good time. Amen to that. I think I'm always having a good time at Goodwill, honestly. If you're from Vermont, your cup's here. It's waiting for you. Now this cup is cool. It was giving me some vintage vibes, but I couldn't confirm it. I looked online to see if I could find a match, and I found similar cups, but nothing quite like that. But I did really like that cup. I thought it was pretty cool. Some leprechaun juice, a little cold koozie, hold your white claws in. That coffee time cup I've definitely seen either at Ross Dress for Less or at Marshall's for sure. I know I've seen it before. I've seen this kind of, I don't know what you call this decor, mountain, Indian, I don't know. I've definitely seen it though in people's homes. Organized educator, somebody didn't want that for their desk. Cloud nine, feeling fine. This would actually make a fantastic soup bowl. And a quirky little nurse cup. I actually don't know any nurses, which is crazy. I feel like I should know at least one. I was excited when I found this because I thought it could be a fun gifted item, but I realized as I was turning it around in my hand that it had a long crack in it. So now I know why it's here. Not a good find. And then I got excited about this, but realized this is one of the Walmart ones and it does have a straw. These cups, or cups, oh my gosh, plates. These plates are beautiful. I really, really like those. And again, I told you, I am very drawn to the blue for some reason. There's more blue. It's everywhere. Kind of like those plates, but there was only two of them. That just wouldn't work for a family of four. And really, I need some small plates. I need small plates and I need bowls. This was some Corel bowls. They had matching plates underneath. Those are always nice when you've got kids in the house. I will say though, if you scrape silverware on those plates, they sound dreadful. Didn't have any price on it. I was a little bit curious about it. This is precious. I don't have space for this, but I love bunnies for Easter. Call me an old lady. I do. I love these plates. This is kind of that 70s vibe look. Very, very cute. They were a little bit more worn than I like, but I did like these plates a lot. I also like these bowls, but there was only three of them. It's so nice to have bowls with handles like this, especially when they get all hot. It's so much easier to get to the table. Little flower dishes, those are cute. It's funny how many like sets you'll find that are in sets of three. And you know that there was more, but one of the plates got destroyed. I thought those were kind of pretty. I'm just not seeing anything. Watch, you guys are probably seeing something and yelling at me. These were cool. Little napkin holders. I really, really liked these. I just don't use napkins.
It's really sad, really, to see all of this, because you know that it was a wedding gift for her and the entire collection never ever made it out of the cabinetry.
Yeah, that's true.
And then the other one that also totally just
want to
cry. Is the punch bowls.
Oh yeah.
We don't do punch bowls anymore.
Yeah. True.
I saw this gingerbread man storage case and thought it would be super cute to put ornaments in. He was only $3. Honestly, if he were a dollar, I probably would have gotten him, but I left him behind. I didn't need him. And this doll was giving me Mimi from the Drew Carey show. Look at that blue eyeshadow. Woof. She pretty. Okay, hear me out. This lady said joy and look at her. Does she not bring you joy? My goodness. She was stinking cute. It's never too late or early to look at Christmas pieces. I love to collect them. I love vintage pieces. Sorry if you guys hear my kiddo in the background because he's hanging out with me today. Let's see. Oh, I really, really liked this Jack in the Box. I thought he would be really fun to put around a Christmas tree or maybe at an entryway. He was a little bit more pricier than I would like to spend though. I want to say he was $13. It's kind of hard to see, but he was just too much for me, especially as a Goodwill find. And this was a candle. I thought this was actually pretty cool. I almost picked it up because I loved his hat, but I left him behind for somebody else. I kind of regret it, but I'll forget about it. It's all right. These were kind of cool. This was a Starbucks set from the 90s. I really like the green ones. The red ones, not so much, but they weren't really my style, so I left them behind for somebody else to enjoy. I love going down these trinket porcelain aisles. I just see so many fun memory things, some sad things that are broken. Poor Pegasus. Ducks from the 90s. I mean, where else are you gonna see this? It's like going back in time. I low-key wish one of my kids was a little bit more sporty, having a sporty room, because that was cute. Little glove and mitt set. Just kind of taking it in. The idea of this was really cute, but it was really cheaply made. I like the idea of having a watering can like that around the house for just my little house plants. How I'm keeping them alive at this point, no idea. I kind of liked this bird. It was very peaceful and pretty. And it was a green tag. It was another one of those things though where it's like I couldn't think of where I would put it, so I left it. It really helps me from over-cluttering my house if I think of things that way. Lots of angels, lots of bunny rabbits happening this time of year. I was kind of curious about what this was, and I realized it was a light cover, and it was very 70s. Honestly, I considered it, but the room I would have wanted to put it in, it doesn't have that kind of light. It actually has a more complicated light. Also, fun fact, I love Christmas mice. The only reason I did not get this was because I didn't like the way his ear looked. It was bugging me. I kind of wish I could have seen both the ears instead of it having it cut off with the flower. I like the colors of this vase, but I just never use vases. I feel like they just kind of sit around and collect dust. Why avoid them? This would be a fun piece to put out at Easter time. I didn't see any chips on it. It'd be fun to put cookies or something cute like that in it. I actually really, really liked this piece. I think it was a candle holder. I'm not 100% sure. It could have also been like something you could put flowers in. But I really liked it. This guy was interesting. A cowboy armadillo. I mean, where else are you gonna see something like that? Taking it all in. I always thought about collecting these little figures without the faces. I've just never committed and decided to do it. But I think that they're precious. My oldest sister actually collects some of these. Let's go to the end here and see. Ew, forgot about these toenails and nose hairs. That's just wrong. That's just sick and wrong. There's actually a local lady that collects teeth. I'm not kidding you. I see her out there on the social web asking for people's teeth, offering them to pay money, and she's showed her jar off before online, and I was like, that's different. Again with the blue, I just can't not pick it up. I'm gonna put it back though. I'm not doing blue. I actually saw this guy last time I was in here. I ended up looking him up and he's an incense holder. I thought maybe he was one of those things you put in the middle of a pie and it whistles. You know what I'm talking about? It's an incense holder though. Cute little Easter basket. I liked this canister too, but I couldn't think of what I would use it for, so I left it. It's funny, as I'm watching this skin, I see things I wish I would have picked up and I just didn't even touch. They had some Pioneer Woman canister things. They're pretty. A little pricey for me though. I don't need them. Little gnome coffee cup with lid. He was kind of sweet. He'd be fun to put in like a little gift basket for somebody. Again with the little faceless figures. Now that I'm thinking about it, maybe I never got into them because my husband doesn't have any hair. It would never look right. Okay, tell me, are these giving you 70s glass grapes? This was totally giving me that. I couldn't read the tag, but I kind of liked it. And more bunnies. These were really cute. I didn't get them because they're not my style, but I can imagine them up on somebody's wall in their kitchen area. And I think they're precious. They had two of them here. One that read diner, and then this other one that said cafe. And they're just fun. They also had a really fun little tin railroad sign, which is kind of cheeky because my name's Raina, my husband's name is Ryan, so R&R has always been a thing, but I left it. These were kind of cool decorative pieces too. Not my style. Kind of reminded me of my sister-in-law actually. This looked like a cool piece you could do something with. Can somebody tell me what state I'm from by looking at this? They had one of those little desktop calendars, which I already know I would be terrible at keeping up. So many smiles begin with you. That's true. case you didn't know. Also, if you didn't know, this area is for good vibes only. So if you're feeling like saying something snarky, this isn't the place for you. I thought this was kind of cool. I kind of wish I would have gotten it, because now that I started thinking about it, this would have been a great little salt pinch bowl for my kitchen. I like to add salt by pinch rather than shaking it out. But oh well, maybe it'll be there next time I go. That's a big clothespin. I thought about this for a second for Valentine decor, but I just didn't quite love it enough to get it. That reminds me of growing up. What are these things? They're like macrame, dream catcher, fish. Definitely interesting. Never seen anything like it. I think this was a bear towel holder. This was my guess anyways. In a world of possibilities, imagine yourself as one. Kind of cute. I prefer hand-painted pieces. Anything print just doesn't appeal to me anymore. Does anybody know how to use these? I don't understand how you count with them. Little drummer boy back there. He should be with the Christmas stuff. A little windmill here. It looks like somebody handmade. A little wooden shoe. Actually, low-key thought about getting this since I know I have some Dutch in my heritage. I really like this, and I'm sad I didn't get it, especially since it was green tag. Why didn't I get that? It's so cute. This turtle and his face is giving me life. Somebody's little handmade turtle. I should have got him. He's a vibe. Gotta check out the baskets. I really like this one. I just don't understand what I would put in it. But the weave in it was really, really pretty. I like the dark pieces. Okay. Don't know what that was. This also had some dark weaving in it and would be a really, really pretty gift basket to somebody. It's the only thing I could really think to use it for, though, because it was kind of an awkward shape. And it wasn't quite big enough to put anything like blankets in. But it was pretty. It had a wonky little elephant. Looks like he was missing an ear. That's too bad. The basket aisle overall was not giving today. It's pretty sad, actually. This was kind of nice. I can imagine putting it in the middle of the table and putting little treats in it. Nuts and, I don't know, some sort of appetizer on the middle of the table. And they had a little baby basket down here. I didn't like the insert. I would replace that, but that could make for a really cute gift basket. And that's it, you guys. That was my whole trip. I ended up purchasing some books, a couple shorts for myself, and it was a nice little outing. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I will be doing some more shop with me, so I hope that you come back. Best way to do that, of course, is to subscribe. And as I always say, take care, love always, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.